Today I'm going to show you how to change the grading scheme in Canvas. This video is for other instructors who want an alternative to the 100-point scale. You can change the grading scheme at the assignment level or the course level. Let's start with the assignment level. Open up one of your assignments in the editing mode and scroll down until you see the options for grade display. Choose letter grade, and a new option will appear to view the grading scheme. Click that and you'll get a pop-up window showing the current grading scheme. By default, it's a 100-point scale with all scores under 60% resulting in a failing grade. If you scroll down to the bottom, you can manage your grading schemes to create a new one. On the management page, you'll see that default scheme again. Add a new one by clicking the button on the right. Give it a name that makes sense based on your grading scheme. That'll make it easy to find later. I'm using a 5-level scheme, so that's the name I'm going to use. I'm also going to delete all of the extra scores that are not part of that 5-level system. So all of the pluses and minuses, I'm just going to take those out by using the X on the right. Now I've got my 5 levels, I need to change my percentages to match. So based on my 4-point scale, I want to have the A range run from 87.5 up to 100. Next level is going to be from 62.5. Next level is going to be 37.5. Next level is 2.5, and the next level goes down to 0. So this is based on a 4-point system where 4 points is an A, 3 points is a B, 2 points is a C, and 1 point is a D. I'm going to go ahead and save that so I can have it display in this manner, A, B, C, D, F, or I can actually put in a different name if I choose. So for an A, I'm going to call that exceeding standards. For a B, I'm going to call that meeting standards. For C, I'm going to call that approaching standards. I'm going to call the D level not yet meeting standards. And then for the F, I'm just going to call that insufficient evidence, where there's not enough evidence of learning to indicate a grade. I can go ahead and save that, and now I have my scale here. So now that I've got my grading scheme saved, I need to go back to that assignment and edit again. Select letter grade, view the grading scheme, and you can see it's still set to the default scheme. Select another scheme and you will find the ones that you saved. Select the correct scheme and use it. Don't forget to press done to save it to the assignment, and then scroll down and save the actual assignment. You can enter scores in the speed grader or enter them manually in the gradebook. I'll go ahead and put in 3 out of 4. For my 4-point grading scale, that's going to be a B. The individual student view shows a little bit more information. Let's go ahead and look at the grade view. This is similar to what your student will see when they look at their grades. They will see both the score and the evaluation level. It's important to make sure that your grading scheme is consistent across all your assignments. Otherwise, your student could be confused about why the same level of percentage results in a different grade. To apply a grading scheme at the course level, go to your settings page. Scroll all the way down to the bottom of your course menu and scroll down until you see the option to enable course grading scheme. When you select that, a new link will appear to set the grading scheme. Just like before, you can select another scheme, and I'm going to select that 5-level scheme that I just created, and be sure to press use this scheme. Then press done, And the last step is to save those details to your course settings. To see how the course grading scheme affected the grades, you can go back to the gradebook. You can see it didn't change any of the grade displays for the individual assignments. It's only going to affect the total grade that appears all the way at the end. And you can see that it still shows the percentage, but it shows meeting standards instead of a letter grade. If you'd like students to have more clarity about what the final grade is, go back to your grading scheme and create a special grading scheme just for final grades. Again, I'm going to go ahead and delete all of the unwanted grades. My college does not use pluses and minuses. And then I'm going to enter that grade range for each one again. Okay, and press save. Now again, I'm going to go to the settings and apply that grading scheme to my course. Be sure to select use this grading scheme, press done, and then save at the bottom. So let's go back to the gradebook to see how that change affects the grade display. It still shows the percentage of the grade, but now it more accurately shows what letter grade I would enter at the college. Whatever grading scheme or range you decide on, focus on language that will encourage your students regardless of their current achievement level. Here are some examples from the teaching resources at Brown University. I'll leave a link in the video description. And if you decide to change your grading scheme, I'd love to hear about your experience in the comments. This is the end.